everyone, and welcome to Roger E. Carlson Fieldhouse for CTN's live coverage of boys high school basketball. Tonight, some Northwest Suburban Conference action between the Coon Rapids Cardinals and the Park Center Pirates. Joe Young and Howie Shapiro, sidelines for tonight's game. And Howie, two teams towards the bottom of the conference pack. One coming in after losing two in a row. The other, Coon Rapids, coming in off of two straight victories and sitting above 500 in conference play for the first time this season.
Yeah, you know, Coach Wilford talked to me that this is an important game for them because they've won two in a row. They've got an opportunity against a team who's really struggled this season, had a lot of off-the-court issues in Park Center, and an opportunity for them to win in their home building and get the fifth win in the conference, which would be very big for them.
And the times that we have had the opportunity to see them, they have played very well. And a place that we've always talked about is tenacity and quickness on the defensive end. That's something they'll be looking for again tonight.
Yeah, and you know, we're going to talk about certain keys when coming up, but defensive rebounds for Coon Rapids. Coach Wilford told me that they've been having a really difficult time. And in the last game against Elk River, even though they got the W, they really struggled in this area. So this is something that they're going to work on tonight, hopefully to control the boards at both ends of the court.
Well, and the Park Center Pirates have a big guy in the middle that's generating some Division I buzz, but they also have a guy that really, the guy that makes their team go is a guy with explosive speed and good skills coming from the perimeter.
Voltaire Niles, he is a very good basketball player. Coach Breitenbacher told me that he is a player that really controls this game. He really plays the game well, and when he plays well, they have an opportunity to win.
And we'll talk more about the power that they have in the middle. A big guy named Casper who looked pretty impressive in the warm-ups. The key for Coon Rapids as well is going to be to pressure the guards, including Knowles, make them move the ball. Don't let anybody get too many good looks. And that means that the guards are going to have to play well at the defensive end. And the nice thing for Coon Rapids is they've got a lot of guys at the guard position that they can rotate in, not just the starters, but guys coming in off the bench.
Yeah, a guy like Cody Beam coming off the bench, and certainly he likes to shoot from the perimeter, and they're going to look for those outside shots. Cody averaging almost 6 points a game. He is somebody that's going to come off that bench, try to provide a spark offensively. And you mentioned the guard play, because Park Center has some quick guards, so they're going to have to rotate guys in and out and really make sure that they stay out of, obviously, foul trouble and limit those opportunities for Park Center.
And, of course, both teams have what they think they need to get done in order to get a victory here tonight for Park Center. The Keys hoping can end of a losing streak.
Well, what they want to do is come in and they want to stop the Cards from running. They know the Cards are very athletic. They're going to run they're going to pressure on defense, but they're going to run the ball up the court. They also want to limit easy baskets, and they've been having a difficult time this year limiting that opportunity. And then patience on offense, that's something that they've been working on all year. They've been really having a trouble with, so that coming in tonight, they really want to have that patience.
And on the Coon Rapids side of the ball,
they want to contain the guard play, as you mentioned. They've got some very good, very athletic guards. They want to limit opportunities. They want to be strong on the defensive boards. They have to really make sure that they limit those opportunities as well. And they want to get off to a good start. Play with energy. Coach Wilford told me that these guys have to play with energy tonight.
Well, we will take a short break and see who will get the energy off the opening tip. The Cardinals and the Pirates take the court next on CTN.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you.
We can't do it without you. Join the March for Babies and help us give every baby a healthy start.
The second season starts right now. Wow, do we have a show for you tonight?
Busy afternoon Monday for firefighters trying to contain several grass fires along.
This is going to be a very good and very close game.
Welcome to Sports Night. I'm Joe Young.
And I'm Howie Shapiro.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Talk of the Town.
Such a big event definitely needs a third man.
All the action, all the emotion, all the excitement. It's all here, Cardinal Sports Live on CTN. Be sure to watch as Coon Rapids takes on Maple Grove in live boys basketball action only on Cable Channel 15.
Back at Roger E. Carlson Fieldhouse, just a couple of minutes away before tip-off between the Coon Rapids Cardinals and the Park Center Pirates. And as we talked about, the Cardinals trying to expand on a two-game win streak. And the Pirates looking to end a two-game losing streak.
And you mentioned too, Joe, earlier, the big center for Park Center, Justin Casey. He's a player that I think we're going to see a nice matchup between him and Ben Baker tonight. I think, you know, both of them are about the same height. Casey's been getting some Division I looks earlier. It's just a junior, as we talked about. And I think, you know, that's going to be kind of a side note to this battle between these two teams. But I think the guard play on both cases in both teams will really decide what this game is going to, the outcome of this game will be.
Yeah, they are of similar size and similar abilities. There is Justin Casey, he was getting pretty easy inside. It should be interesting to watch the big boys go at it underneath at both ends of the court. There's Ben Baker, who we were talking about as his opposite number. Take a look at the starters in hole. Therese Van Pelt, the point guard for Park Center. Voltaire Knowles, Lorenzo McClellan back in the backcourt with him. Jordan Lynn and Justin Casey up front. For the Cardinals, Adam Nagley, Mike Lana, and Blair Townsend on the perimeter. Ben Baker and Abo Nanaquason starting up front.
Our officials tonight, Dwayne Starr, Chuck Healy, and Tim Hatch will be calling all the action here this evening. We also got a look at head coach for Park Center, David Breitenbucker. There's head coach Aaron Wolford, head coach of Coon Rapids.
His sixth season.
Yeah, I think so.
Could be his fifth.
Fifth or sixth, we were trying to figure that out before the game.
Townsend and Casey will jump at center court to get this one underway.
Head coach Breitenbucker, third season.
And Casey got it on the way down, so we'll try it again.
You know, we're going to see two very...
Townsend might have got up a little higher.
Yeah.
Got it that time and swatted it way down into the Cardinal corner where Baker recovers. Nanaquason will bring it up court. Stops up high on the right wing, up top for Nagley. Townsend now has Casey all the way out at the top of the key. And it's Knowles that's lining up on D against Ben Baker. And now inside to Townsend. Drops it off, Lada won't go, got his own rebound, that won't go. Rebound control by Perez.
Oh, you talked about Knowles, he's very athletic.
Van Pelt, rather. Van Pelt the shot and it's good. Townsend got in the air and was fouled. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
And we're going to see the Cardinals bring the action inside two as well.
And Townsend gets the Cardinals on the board for the first time from the free throw line. And Townsend hits them both.
And as this game unfolds, you know, free throw shooting will be very important. Opportunities from the line for both sides.
Swan's pass almost picked off. But good redirect, and McClellan scores underneath, plus the foul.
Yeah, it was important. Good body control by McClellan, able to stay in the air enough to get the basket in and pick up the foul.
Lotta going to pick up his first. Misses on the free throw. Townsend the rebound.
Park Center coming in here, a loss to Champlin Park, 76-52. And McClellan was the leading scorer that evening, 14 points on the night.
Baker, the right-hander, won't go. The rebound by Knowles, or Van Pelt, rather.
A little too much on that one by Ben off that back iron.
Long two-pointer is short. Nagley the rebound. Not a Quason in the lane, had it knocked away by Casey. Townsend recovers the loose ball. Right side for Baker. He'll put up the three. It won't go. Nagley the rebound. Not a Quason for three. That one won't go either. Townsend, the follow is good.
Good hustle by Blair. Able to get through and pick that loose ball up and put it in.
Jump shot rattles out for Van Pelt. The rebound by Lotta. Cardinals on the run. We'll slow it down. Now Quason driving baseline score.
A strong move to the hoop by Abo.
Three-pointer is short. For Knowles, long rebound and on a Quason. Nagley will take it inside. Now looking to pass. Rotated to not a Quason. Baker on the drive shot won't go. Casey with the rebound. Driving at the other end, his shot won't go. Knowles the rebound, his follow won't go. Casey's still slow getting up at the other end. A foul will put Baker at the line to shoot two.
Yeah, he took a hard fall and he's limping, looking to come over to the bench. I'm not sure if he's gonna. Yeah, he's calling to the coaching staff. Doug Block is gonna come in. Number 54, Park Center. He took a fall underneath when he was trying to drive to the basket. Did Casey.
First one misses. Cody Beam onto the floor for Coon Rapids for the first time.
The Pirates will go about eight deep this evening, and we'll see a little more bench play from Coon Rapids tonight.
Baker hits the second. 7-4 lead, Coon Rapids. Van Pelt into the corner. Jump shot, three-pointer for Swan, didn't go. Rebound, knocked to the floor, tied up. Possession arrow favors the Pirates.
And that was a hustle by Voltaire Knowles. Voltaire Knowles, as he was able to knock that ball away. And really
Townsend
get
looked like he
back.
Had it, but
yep.
Knowles got a hand in on it. Baker got a hand in on the pass. Great play by Abel, but good recovery by Swan. Baker is going to get the foul to put Knowles at the line for two.
Foul called on, as you mentioned, Ben Baker on the arm. We're going to see it again here.
It looked like the Cardinals might get the steal. Good recovery by Swan.
I'm surprised he didn't call a foul initially there. He was on the back of Knowles.
Knowles hits the first. Second one is short. Baker the rebound.
Cardinals looking to run. Nagley inside to Townsend. Low post, working against block. Back out. Long jump shot for Beam is good. So Beam checks into the game and automatically has an impact.
Well, they look for his scoring from outside, and you know, he brings a little spark off the bench.
Shot won't go. Townsend the rebound. Beam in the corner into Baker. Baker turns around, won't go. Rebound tipped around, finally controlled by Swan.
That time Ben lost control of the basketball going up for it in the Park Center. Player hit, could have hit him on the wrist a little bit.
Off the glass for a block, won't go. Not a Quace in the rebound. Nanaquason driving, got the foul, it'll count. He'll have a chance to make it a three-point play.
Oh, such a nice move by Abel.
And that's number two on McClellan.
He faked the pass, drew the defense the other way, and he was able to take it to the bucket for the basket and an opportunity for a three-point play. Torin Dowdy coming into the game for Coon Rapids. And Nagley back into the lineup.
Tony Dubois checking in for the Pirates.
7-point lead for Coon Rapids here early in this first half.
Casey working against Baker, gets the hook shot to go.
Casey backing him off with the body, able to get that hook in.
Dowdy trying to get it inside. Nalls got up and got the steal.
Oh, Nalls has hops. We were watching him in warm-up dunk the basketball.
Blocked by Abo on Dubois. Cardinals running. Dowdy is fouled. He'd go to the line and shoot two.
Well, you and I talked about Torin Dowdy earlier today, and he is such an exciting basketball player. He's got great speed, able to gain the corner to the basket there. An opportunity from the charity stripe. See if he can put a couple of points in.
And he misses the first of his two free throws.
Mike Latta back into the action for Coon Rapids.
And Dowdy able to hit the second. 13-7 Coon Rapids lead. Dubois into Casey, tried to dunk and bricked it. Nagley turning it up court for Coon Rapids. Good feed to Baker underneath for the bucket.
Oh, just a nice pass from Cody Beam inside to Ben Baker. That was easy. And off that missed dunk, Coon Rapids comes down quickly and scores.
Three-pointer for Dubois, won't go. Casey the rebound. He got the foul. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
Casey realized that on that dunk opportunity, he just went up a little bit too hard, hit it off that back iron. But you can see the athletic moves in Justin Casey. Very, very strong around the bucket.
Misses the first free throw opportunity. Jordan Lynn checking in for the first time tonight for... He was supposed to be in the starting lineup, but just now checking in, I believe. As Swan got to the start, full court pressure from Park Center. Three-pointer for Baker is short. Long rebound picked up by Casey. He's on the run. He got the foul, and the bucket will count.
Oh, nice move by Casey. Cardinals couldn't set their feet on defense. Casey took advantage of it. He was going to go to the hoop as soon as he got the basketball. We'll see it right here.
Misses the extra point opportunity, but the rebound out of bounds to Park Center. working the perimeter. Swan left side for Casey inside. His first shot won't go. Beam gets the rebound, then lost the handle. Out of bounds. Pirate ball.
Fans calling for the foul. That time you could see off the Cardinal player out of bounds. Park Center doing a good job trying to cut back into this lead down by five with the basketball.
Swan down to Nalls in the corner for three. It's short. Rebound by Doughty. Jumper beam is good.
Now, Torin Doughty just brings the excitement into this basketball game. He's so good off
quick.
The feed. Very quick, but off the feed. And Beam puts in the basket from the outside to put the lead back to seven.
Van Pelt high on the left side. Top driving is Casey. That won't go. Nonequation couldn't control it. Casey was blocked by Townsend.
Now, a nice athletic move by Blair Townsend to get the block.
Nalls driving, and it's going to be a charge.
This time, Cardinals had their feet set on defense. Tony Dubois coming back into the game for Park Center.
Doughty underneath, blocked by Casey. Lotta had it and then lost it. Nalls has it now.
A quick hands that time by Voltaire Nalls.
Nalls jumper at the other end won't go. Swan comes in, gets the rebound and the follow.
That time Lotta went up for the rebound and it bounced off the front part of the rim and just over his grasp.
Beam driving and gets the roll.
Nice move by Cody Beam. Able to gain the corner.
Van Pelt, pass tipped, but Nall's able to recover it. Leaves it off for Casey, he lost it. Recovered by Townsend.
That's Wolfer calling out to
Townsend
mismatch.
And Swan recognized it as well, and he grabbed on to Blair Townsend away from the ball.
That's already the 16 foul
Swan's
on the Pirates.
Second. Jordan Lynn checks back in, and now they're moving guys in and out pretty quickly off this bench. To our left, Derek Payne in for the first time. Nagley to inbound. Beam gives it back to Nagley in the corner.
Well, Adam was looking to shoot but thought better of it, had Nalls on him.
Beam working against Dubois. Ran into Townsend. Nonequation on the baseline. It wouldn't go. A lot of body. And then the foul's going to be called on Baker.
Yeah, they called Ben for the reach in. I think that's his second.
It is indeed.
I believe team fifth.
Oh.
No?
No, they're going to.
Are they going to?
Derek Payne picked up the foul. And it's going to put
Coach Breitbooger not happy with that call. We're going to take another look at that.
Oh, yeah, he grabbed his jersey
yep.
from behind. Okay.
Yep.
No. Ben Baker at the line for a 1-1. Hits the first, earns the second. And he hits them both. It's a 9-point Coon Rapids lead. Van Pelt down into the corner. Jump shot wouldn't go for Payne. Baker rips away the rebound.
That was a good job by Ben to get his dribble back before the travel.
Recognize Nalls behind the defense. He dunks it plus the foul. Townsend doesn't agree.
I'm not sure he got any of them on that particular play, but we'll if we get a chance to see the replay. But a nice move by Nalls. We talked about it. We watched him in warm-ups dunk the basketball.
Huh?
I don't think he even touched him. Not sure what the our official saw in that to call the infraction.
And Alls misses it. Quick putback is good for Tony Dubois.
Yeah, it was a nice move by Tony Dubois to get the rebound, went over the outstretched arm of Blair Townsend.
Baker scores at the other end. Good quick passing broken up by Townsend. Cardinals with the numbers. Townsend kicks it back out. Nonequason jump shot off the glass and in.
Sometimes the glass is your best friend. Abel able to use it to get the bucket. 9-point lead for the Cardinals.
Floating jumper won't go for Van Pelt. The rebound by Baker. Baker up top and he traveled. Yeah, yeah. Thought about the three. Casey's going to check back on the floor for Park Center. 7:50 to play.
Early in this ball game, Casey took a fall, but doesn't look like that's bothering him at this point. Came off immediately after that happened.
Casey going up over Baker. The shot won't go. The rebound by Eitenauer quickly to the other end. Pass tipped away. It'll be Coon Rapids ball.
I thought Townsend saw Baker streaking to the basket, just one defender between the two of them, but good job by Park Center to get a hand on that pass.
Nagley, quick three off the inbound, doesn't go. Nall's able to control the rebound. Nice crossover. Underneath, the bucket for Jordan Lynn.
Good job feeding the basketball underneath.
Nonequason answers.
Now both teams back and forth. Park Center going to talk about a call timeout here, Joe. 27-18, Coon Rapids leads with 7:07 remaining in this opening half.
Nine points in this first half for Abo Nonequason.
We talked about Coon Rapids, their last game against Elk River, the 75-62 victory. Ben Baker with 26 points, 8 rebounds in that contest. Some of the things we'll talk about on Sports Night this week, swimming and diving, Maple Grove and Coon Rapids, gymnastics, Cardinals against Centennial, and then Coon Rapids wrestling with a big win over Centennial.
Meant to check the StarTrip website about that this morning and did not get to it. Payne in the corner throws it away.
Well, actually,
double team by Coon Rapids.
It was a triangle between Centennial, Sibley, and Coon Rapids, and Coon Rapids beat. It was a closer match between Coon Rapids and Sibley than it was between Coon Rapids and Centennial.
And that will almost guarantee a bad pass for Coon Rapids at this end. All or nothing showdown.
With Anoka.
At Anoka. Yep. Sloppy basketball back and forth. Lotta will end it with a little jump shot off the glass.
That pushes the lead to 11 for the Cardinals.
Van Pelt back to Nalls on the near side. Lynn back cross court in the lane. Van Pelt hits the jumper.
Yeah, nice athletic move by Van Pelt.
Casey with a block on Baker.
Well, maybe an ill-advised shot by Ben Baker. There were three white jerseys right there as he tried to gain the inside.
Van Pelt kicks it out. Payne from the corner. It's good for three.
It'll cut the lead to six.
Eitenauer with a toe on the line hits it.
A lot of different players contributing tonight for Coon Rapids.
Van Pelt for three. It's short. Casey gets to the rebound. Casey misses. Lada is going to be called for the foul.
Cardinals will retain the basketball. Abel Nanaquason in the game for Coon Rapids, back in the action.
Nanaquason driving, got the foul, who gets in line to draw, shoot two.
Abel with 9 points, make it 10 on the evening.
Number 50, Doug Block, the Cardinals. Number 32, Blair Townsend.
Blair Townsend checking back on the floor. And Abel hits them both.
Took a little while for the scoreboard to catch up with the actual score.
Three-pointer is good for Knowles.
Walter Knowles, very good basketball player. Great court presence. Good distributor, good shooter from the outside.
Ball tipped away, the Cardinals will slow it down. Got a hand in on it, diving for it is Dubois. A timeout called by Park Center.
Yeah, smart timeout by the Pirates before they lost possession of the basketball. ...33-27 is where we stand with 4:06 remaining in this opening half. Coon Rapids' lead was up to 11 at one point. Credit to Park Center for not folding and working back and trying to continue to cut into that lead. 6-point deficit for them, but with the basketball.
Couple of big three-pointers.
Yep.
In the last couple of minutes.
Not a bad crowd here tonight, Joe. I think it's the biggest crowd we've seen at a basketball game this year.
Could be true. Knowles cutting back, driving to the lane, and scoring off the glass.
Great job under control by Knowles. Lead is four for Coon Rapids.
See, now, I have it at five. I believe they're only supposed to have 28. Because they had 20, and since then they've hit two three-pointers, and then that last drive. Cardinals running into defense twice. And I believe that's two blocks for Jordan Lynn. Back to back.
Casey back into the ball game for the Pirates.
Go, Van Pelt drops it underneath. And Lynn got fouled. He was so far underneath he couldn't have scored, but he draws the foul, gets the line to shoot two.
In fact, his shot went off the bottom of the rim.
Abo Nanaquason picking up his first.
A couple of points off the evening for Jordan Lynn.
Hit the first. And misses the second. Beam recovered it, but was then fouled immediately by Dubois. That's his second. And it'll put Beam at the line to shoot a one and one.
Cody hits the first.
And he hits them both.
That pushes a lead to five for the Cardinals. We hit the 3 minute mark remaining in the opening half.
That three pointer won't get it. Go Casey, the rebound and his follow is good.
He has hops, there's no doubt about it. He can get up there, and a nice job just on the turnaround for the bucket.
Nall's getting a hand in on it. Able to get it to Dubois somehow, but he missed the jumper. Body's flying. Baker finally able to recover it. Beam. Let's Nalls fly by. The shot won't go. Casey the rebound.
Well, we've seen a fair amount of sloppy basketball here in this opening half by both squads.
It's one way of putting it.
Yeah.
Under 2 minutes remaining first half. Nalls driving, dumps it off. Dubois bobbled it.
What about Ben?
It is going to be against Ben Baker.
His third.
Second.
Oh, second.
Remember, we thought the second
That's right.
Actually Payne pulling him from behind. Either way, it'll put Dubois at the line to shoot a one and one. And he misses the front end. Rebound tipped. Finally controlled by Van Pelt. Three-pointer for Nalls, rattles around and out. Abo the rebound. Quickly to the other end on Equason, the bucket and the foul.
Good control by Abo as he's able to make sure that he got the bucket before. You're going to see it again. There's a nice move, give it back from Wada. Good control by Abo. He picks up the infraction, an opportunity for a three-point play, and the Cardinals needed it.
And he does. 14 for Abo tonight.
Cody Beam back in the lineup for the Cardinals. Ben Baker's going to take a spot on the bench.
Van Pelt for Nalls up top. Into the corner, Dubois. Back up top, Nalls underneath. And the bucket and a foul as Lynn slid in.
Mike Latta picking up the infraction.
There's a foul on the play by number 20, Mike Latta, his second.
That'll be Latta's second. You can see it underneath.
And Lynn able to convert. Beam slowing it down. Into the corner for Abo. Up top, Beam driving in the lane. The floater won't go. Lynn the rebound.
And that was a dangerous pass from Abo as well. under a minute.
Van Pelt's drive off the glass and in. And the on the board, it's a one-point game.
Let's see if the Cardinals decide to play for the last shot.
I still say the board has one extra. Abo's shot doesn't go. Casey, the rebound, unofficially his ninth.
Pirates with an opportunity to take the lead into the break.
Like a fadeaway hook shot that wouldn't go. The rebound tied up between Dubois and Lotta, and Lotta is going to get the foul. And it is a technical.
Yep, they're going to tee him up.
Against Mike Lotta.
In a jump ball situation, but during the skirmish, we had a technical foul called the Cardinals number 20, Mike Lotta.
And that'll put Dubois at the line to shoot a couple, and the Pirates will get the ball.
Well, see, here's where they call the technical. There's a little too much pushing, and Blair Townsend tried to hold Lotta back.
Dubois 0 for 1 at the free throw line tonight. We'll have two shots here and the ball.
Where's the noise in this building from this home crowd?
And the game is tied with 7.7 seconds remaining first half. And Park Center now. It's first lead since 4-2.
Torin Dowdy into the game for Coon Rapids with 7.7 seconds remaining in this opening half. Cardinals at 1 point, up by 11.
I still say it's tied. And that's a travel as Van Pelt was falling in the backcourt. Coon Rapids will have 4.6 seconds.
Baker's going to get back in the lineup before Coon Rapids will inbound the ball.
Blair Townsend pulls up, shoots around Casey. Won't go, the rebound by Knowles, and Park Center will go to the locker room with a 39-38 lead after Coon Rapids had a double-digit advantage midway through. We'll have more from Roger E. Carlson right after this.
We've heard a lot lately about how families are struggling to make ends meet. Many of them will need help this winter to pay their heating bills. Fortunately, the Salvation Army's Heat Share program is there, helping families in crisis pay their heating bills when they have nowhere else to turn. HeatShare relies on funding from utilities like CenterPoint Energy and the generous contributions of customers. Please help. Make a donation today by contacting the Salvation Army at 1-800-SAL-ARMY. The family you help could be right next door. This message brought to you by CenterPoint Energy.
Once you post your image online, you can't take it back. Anyone can see it. Family, friends, anyone. Remember, think before you post.
Hey, guys. Thanks for coming.
Are we in trouble?
No, you're not in trouble. I just want to set some ground rules.
Like what?
Well, remember last week when you hit Vinny in the head with the shovel?
I do not recall that.
Of course not. Well, it was pretty graphic. Too graphic for the kids. So I'm going to have to block you.
You know, I got to make this up to you. This is Vinny's watch, and I want you to have it. You deserve it.
Oh, thank you. That's really not necessary.
No. Come here.
Ah, it's a great day, isn't it?
Yeah. Too bad your boat's going to sink at 11:05.
Don't come closer. I have rabies. Don't you wish there were warnings to protect you from life's risks? With diabetes, there is one. It's called A1C, a simple blood test that helps measure your risk of a heart attack and other complications. Learn more at diabetesa1c.org.
Joey Young and Howie Shapiro with you on the sidelines. Howie, what looks like a very nice night, but it is cold and windy here at the store.
You look at this matchup on paper, and there's no contest, but this game is not played on paper. And you know, in this conference, anything can happen.
Anderson drops back to pass, has a little time. And he will pitch again, and Muhlenberg running right.
And Howie, a big opponent coming in for the Coon Rapids Cardinals. This defense only giving up 11 points a game.
Those, locusts?
What?
Those locusts?
Yeah. I'm throwing rocks at some stuff, and next thing I know, locusts.
Sounds like bad karma. You should try volunteering or walking a little old lady across the street or, you know, something good.
Interesting.
Stay on the universe's good side. Volunteer, vote, get involved.
All the action, all the emotion, all the excitement. It's all here, Cardinals Sports Live on CTN. Be sure to watch as Coon Rapids takes on Maple Grove in live boys basketball action only on Cable Channel 15.
Back at Roger E. Carlson Fieldhouse, Park Center with a 39-38 lead over Coon Rapids, although early on it was the Cardinals that sparked the early lead. A nice little run put them in front. Casey's been a problem inside. He's got a lot of rebounds, 9 boards. Only 7 points, but the big dunk by Voltaire Knowles and then the phantom foul. He did not hit that free throw, but they got a rebound putback, so it was a 4-point trip thanks to the phantom foul. No question about that foul there. Abo's been hot. 14 points, just a couple of boards and a block.
You know, I think Cardinals lost focus a little bit during that game. You know, they had that 11-point lead, and they let it slip away. And you look at the rebounds heavily in the favor of Park Center, 27-18. The Cardinals have to do a better job on the boards here in the second half. I think it's something that they'll have to continue to work on, and I would imagine Coach Wilford a little bit upset with his squad after losing focus in that with that 11-point lead.
Yeah, Casey has been a monster in the middle, but Therese Van Pelt, their point guard, getting a lot of rebounds. They have given up a lot of rebounds that have come a good distance away from the rim, and more of those going to Park Center, and most unfortunately for Coon Rapids, a lot of those in their defensive end, so offensive boards for Park Center.
Yeah, and that's some of the thing we talked about, defensive rebounds. Coon Rapids having a difficult time, had a difficult time against Elk River, but they did enough to obviously to get the win. But I think as this continues, they're going to have to make some adjustments.
And now for your halftime enjoyment, the Coon Rapids Cardettes. Rapids Cardettes. And now we will take another break, and we will be back with the second half from Roger E. Carlson right after this.
The odds of a child being in a fatal automobile accident are 1 in 23,000. The odds of a child being diagnosed with autism, 1 in 166. The odds say it's time to listen. To learn the signs of autism, visit autismspeaks.org.
Back at Roger E. Carlson Fieldhouse, we start the second half with Park Center leading Coon Rapids 39-38.
Cody Beam getting the start here in the second half.
All right, we had talked to the scorekeepers about the fact that we had him at 38 all, and now there is some discussion with the Park Center coaches, the referees, and the scoreboard operators.
I'll see if they make any changes.
Yeah, they do. It's 38 all. Way to go, CTN crew. So we'll start with 18 minutes of basketball. Cardinals start with the ball. 18 minutes of basketball to determine the winner.
I think one of the adjustments the Cardinals have to make on the defensive end, Joe, is just really try and we talked about stop that guard play and the athleticism that Park Center is showing here in the first half.
And they could use a little bit better rebounding and not giving up so many second look chances. Nall's got a hand in on the pass, knocked it away. Cardinals will keep it. Nall's matching up against Baker. He's a little bit shorter, but he's got some very good quickness.
Oh, and he's got some great hops. He's got elevation. We talked about, we watched him in the warm-ups, and we saw the dunk earlier in that first half.
Cardinals working to Abo down low on the left side. Nagley for three. It's short. Nall's has the rebound.
And nobody there on that side for the Cardinals.
Van Pelt. For Nalls, his three-pointer won't go. Beam the rebound. Townsend for three. That won't go. Rebound controlled by Nagley, and then he's fouled. And he's called for a double dribble after their feet got tangled up, apparently.
Apparently.
Okay. We've seen nothing but three-point attempts early on. In the first minute of this second half. Not what you'd expect in a tie game. Really? Casey in the lane. The hook shot won't go. Townsend the rebound. Cardinals want to run. They've got the numbers. Baker backdoor score.
Great job by Cody Beam to realize that he had Baker trailing and pulled the defense over to him, able to sneak the pass inside, and Baker gets the bucket.
Long shot by Van Pelt won't go. Another rebound for Townsend. Three-pointer for Nagley is good.
Yeah, good job by Coon Rapids to move it down middle, and Nagley alone outside on the wing for the three. Cardinals with the five-point lead.
Nall's in the right corner, up top to Van Pelt. Townsend got a hand in on the pass, and then it was stolen right back by McClellan, who drives the lane and gets the foul. He'll get to the line, a good shoot, too.
Now Baker has three. I'm not sure I agree with that that fraction, Joe. I think he had position in the middle. I think it was the offensive player should have been called for the foul, but what do I know?
Quinlan did not appear to be in complete control.
However, he misses the first. Now 0 for 2 from the free throw line tonight. And he missed them both, but Casey has the rebound, another big offensive board. And he puts it back. He's got 10 rebounds unofficially. Nagley, another three-point look. This one won't go. Townsend, the rebound. It was tied up with Casey.
That was an awful quick tie-up to get that call.
In the lane, the shot is good for McClellan.
A short little soft jumper from McClellan to get the bucket to cut the lead to one.
And another steal by Swan going the other way, and a foul will put McClellan back at the line.
They're going to call that one on Abel.
His second. And McClellan hits the first.
Fans very vocal here tonight, letting the officials know they don't agree with their calls.
What? You yourself have admitted there.
No, I understand.
And McClellan gets the roll to hit them both and put Park Center back in front. Baker leaves it off. Beam driving baseline. Gets the bucket off the glass. In the post is Casey. His shot won't go. Abel has the rebound. Nagley for three. Won't go. Rebound control by Townsend.
Well, Blair doing a great job on the boards.
Foul before the shot.
Mike Swan called for the infraction.
Townsend inbound from the baseline, gets it to Nagley. Townsend in the corner, back to Nagley. Beam. Inside, the pass skipped through Baker's hands.
Yeah, and it was a nice look, too, inside by Cody Beam. It's just a little bit too much mustard on it. A
little bit. It was smoked in there.
Almost took out our camera.
Nalls will inbound. Van Pelt will bring it up court. Swan to McClellan. Nalls. Van Pelt can't find a way in. McClellan driving, dumped it off. It got away from Lynn, and a turnover back to Coon Rapids.
A quick move inside by Park Center.
Well, the Pirates with a pretty quick lineup on the floor. They essentially have four guards and one guy in the middle in Jordan Lynn.
A lot of quickness out there for the Pirates.
Mike Latta left side. Up top for Beam. Pass tipped away by Van Pelt. McClellan will take him on the run. Right side, Nalls got a piece of it. Townsend, Latta turns it around. And now the Cardinals will slow it just a little. And a foul. It's going to go against Van Pelt. No, it's going to go against Swan, his third.
Coon Rapids trying to move that ball inside, trying to use that mismatch in size that they have on the court right now, but they're going to bring Justin Casey back into the action. And as you mentioned, Swan with that third person.
Off the inbound, the three-pointer won't go. Baker's follow won't go. Lotta got it back. And it'll be Coon Rapids' ball.
Joe Young calling for the slap on the wrist.
Townsend will bring it back up top.
When the Cardinals have that look inside, they have to finish.
Baker back out to Nagley. Beam thought about the shot. Back to Nagley for three. It's good.
Just a good job of moving the ball around and finding that open look from outside. And Nagley hitting from way downtown.
McClellan looking for the answer. It won't go. The rebound. He got the rebound back. Oh, goodness. Little fadeaway jumper is good for Van Pelt.
Beam throwing that one away. Had Townsend underneath, but passed way too long. 48-46, Coon Rapids on top, 12-29 remaining in the ball game.
Torin Dowdy checking back on the floor. Blair Townsend has had a pretty solid second half so far.
Yep.
Flying all over, several rebounds. Got him for a block as well. Couple of three-pointers for Adam Nagley, though. The big difference makers. Casey, the turnaround jumper is good. Plus number four against Ben Baker.
Ben's got to be careful he doesn't lose his cool. He's going after the official, trying to explain to him what he was doing. Had his hands in the air. But that's not going to work.
And Casey can give Park Center the lead again. But he misses. The rebound controlled by Lynn. His follow won't go. A chance for McClellan. The double pump won't go. Casey finally gets it to go. And it's a 50-48 lead. And a foul, I believe, will put Torin Dowdy at the line to shoot two.
Talking about the clock wasn't running, didn't start. They're talking about it.
There was some confusion earlier. The call at the other end of the court was on the Cardinals number 14, Ben Baker. That was his fourth. Now down at the other end.
Ben still ball talking to the officials about.
He's trying to plead his case, but it's not going to do him any good. Foul on Casey down here at the other end. As you mentioned, Dowdy going to the line for an opportunity.
Baker obviously frustrated. Our scoreboard has put two more points on the
52-48.
On the Pirates side this time. Last time it was one. This time they giving them two extra. Torin Dowdy hits the first.
Baker will sit on the bench with that four personals. Blair Townsend coming back for Coon Rapids.
And Dowdy hits them both.
Cardinals are going to call timeout.
That should tie the game at 50 by my calculation, by our calculation. But, again, I don't know where those 2 points came from. They had it right when Van Pelt hit the turnaround jumper.
Correct.
And then he went to the line, and he missed. But then it bounced around, and he had the putback on the fourth opportunity. And that made it. The putback should have made it 50-48, and now, I don't know. They had it right when Casey turned, and he tied the game. And he went to the line, and he missed. He got the putback to make it 50-48.
Correct.
And now Dowdy scored two. I don't believe there was another basket in there. Well, and these are things that the Coon Rapids coaching staff and bench should really be the ones to notice, not the announcers, the non. So I guess Park Center will come up the floor with the ball and the 2 point lead. 3-pointer for McClellan, hard. Rebound controlled by the Cardinals. A lot of nice job battling for it. Cardinals on the run. And Dowdy able to hit the jumper.
Nice adjustment by Torn. Let the defender go past him, able just to make a little move and put the bucket in. Now we're tied at 52, apparently.
Good quick movement. Van Pelt underneath. Swan nowhere to go with it. Back outside. Up top, McClellan. Knowles in the near side. Cross court. Van Pelt up top. And now Knowles will take the three. It won't go. The rebound by Nagley.
Right time, Park Center trying to move that ball around the perimeter, looking for that open look.
Dowdy lost the handle. It'll stay with Coon Rapids. And no, it won't. It will be Park Center ball. Tony Dubois will check in for Park Center. Nagley got a hand in on the pass. Dowdy on the run. And he'll get the foul on Knowles and go back to the line.
Now, good foul by Knowles because Dowdy would have had the bucket. Now he's going to make a merchant from the stripe. The fourth team personal on the Pirates.
Dowdy will put Coon Rapids back in front. He scored the last five for the Cardinals. Second one rims out. Casey the rebound. Again, the Pirates working it around the perimeter. And McClellan for three, it's good.
Well, now you have to decide as a defense, you step out and put a man on those shooters.
One just rolls out for Abo. Quickly at the other end, McClellan gets the foul, gets the line to shoot two. That'll be the first, I believe, on Blair Townsend. It's his second. McClellan hits the first.
McClellan will shoot one more.
And he hits them both. A 4 point Park Center lead. Top of the key, Abo. Left side, Nagley will take the three. It won't go. And a foul underneath.
Call that a Dubois, I believe. Yep.
You are correct. So incredibly observant. That's number three on him.
Thanks, Kelly. I appreciate the
No problem.
The backup.
Good defense by the Pirates forces the Cardinals to call. And apparently he didn't call it. And they're going to give the Pirates the ball. Townsend went over to the bench and said, I called it at four.
I saw him call it.
I saw him call it as well. And Aaron Wilfried, all he can do is shake his head as the ref tries to explain it. Another three-pointer for McClellan is short. Rebound is out, and it will be Pike Park Center ball.
Wish somebody would explain that call to me.
Under 10 minutes to play. McClellan, another three-point, and this one is good.
The Cardinals have to step out, and they have to get a defender on the perimeter shooting because they are getting hot from the outside, especially McClellan.
He has their last 8 points. Nagley back up top for Townsend. Doughty will take it to the lane, ripped away by Casey.
Carter's reverting a little bit to that sloppy basketball.
They need a timeout, but who knows if the refs would know what the what the signal meant. I'm sorry, I couldn't.
He couldn't resist saying that. I know. It just came out, just slipped out.
Nagley got a hand in on the pass, knocked it away, but it'll stay with Park Center. Cody Beam going to check in for the Cardinals. Doughty got a hand in on it. McClellan able to save it. Knowles high on the right side, now Dubois near midcourt. Looking for room on the left, into Casey in the post. Turns and shoots, won't go. And he's gonna get fouled for going up and over the back.
Yep.
On Blair Townsend, who had position. It's his third.
Sixth team foul on the Pirates, so they're one. Cardinals are 1-1, one away from the 1-1.
Beam gets it into Townsend in the high post, working against Casey. Tried to hand it off to Lotta, and the ball lost out of bounds to Park Center. Haven't seen any scoring in the last two minutes, and the Cardinals haven't scored in about the last four.
Therese Van Pelt coming back into the game for the Pirates. Park Center, just three wins on the season.
Foul called away from the ball. He's going to go against either Casey or... Casey or Swan. It's going to go against... or Lynn, rather. Jordan Lynn.
That's Jordan Lynn.
Got a little blood that they're going to have to take care of, Jordan Lynn.
Now Swan will come back in his stead. And now...
Well, it's probably the most disorganized game I have ever seen. Officials having a difficult time getting control of this one.
Dowdy was slipping and lost his foot, and Alls takes the turnover the distance for the basket.
A good basketball.
9-point lead.
Good basketball players take advantage of miscues. That time Nall's doing that for the Park Center.
Beam, a floater that won't go. The rebound out of bounds. It'll stay with Coon Rapids.
I actually think that one went off of Cody. But the Cardinals will take it.
Well, it would have surprised me had they gotten it right.
Ouch.
Again, I couldn't resist. Pass goes out to Abo. His toe was on the line. That'll be two. And boy, just a fraction of his toe was on the line.
Our Cardinals need to stop on defense.
Trying to get it into Casey. Townsend nearly had the steal, but Abo does come away with it. Townsend for three. Won't go. Lotta had a hand in on it. Casey controls it.
Quick hands again by the Cardinals. I think that was Townsend again. He got a hand in.
Three for Abo. Won't go. Rebound again controlled by Casey. That'll be number three on Blair.
The fifth team foul of the second half. That game for the Cardinals, number 14, Ben Baker.
And Jordan Lynn going to check back in. Hand all taped up now.
Ben Baker also with those four personals coming into the game.
6:23 left. See if Park Center decides to go right at him, knowing he's playing with those four.
It'd be smart to do that.
They get it to Lynn in the left corner. Now back up top to McClellan. Step up jumper won't go for Van Pelt. Dowdy swatting at the rebound. It ends up out of bounds to Park Center. Bodies fly
all over the place.
I mean, and just no
full
call.
Full contact basketball.
It was before this. It turned out he just sort of got knocked to the floor.
Maybe they need four officials out. Maybe they need four officials out here tonight to get
well, some. Just they just need one to actually watch the game. Sorry.
That's okay.
Okay.
That's right. I think you're going to be using up your quota of attacking the officials here in tonight's game.
Call like I see it. And apparently they haven't.
Or unable to.
Hook shot wouldn't go for Block. The rebound controlled by Lynn and a timeout call by Park Center bench. How did he see that timeout call?
Well, he screamed. He heard this. He didn't see it. He heard it. 5:42 remaining. Coon Rapids trailing by seven. We were tied up at the break. And just a very interesting game. Interesting called game here tonight. I guess that's all we can say about it.
Well, and I guarantee this is the first time I have ever seen two, in my opinion, scoreboard errors that have favored the visiting team. One of those corrected, one of those still.
Still yet
we
to be
believe
corrected.
Yeah. To be.
Of course, as you always say, unofficial. But you think the score, you know, it's...
I don't know. Watch the tape. Rewind to the begin of the beginning of the Park Center run, where it was 48-44 after Nagley's three-pointer, and then Van Pelt hit a jumper. Casey hit the turnaround, then missed the free throw, but it was able to get put back. And in those, for those three baskets, which they should get 2 points for each of them, they actually got 8 points for those three. I'm no math major, but I'm not sure that's how.
Even us with Minneapolis math, we can try and figure that one
out. So I may have missed one, but I don't think I did. Drive by Van Pelt won't go. Block the rebound. I think Doughty might have gotten a piece of that from behind, and there is a foul. Van Pelt doesn't agree, but.
Casey coming back into the game for the Pirates.
That's his second personal foul. It's team's eighth. In for the Pirates, number 44, Justin Casey.
Beam at the line to shoot a 1-1. Hits the first.
Big free throws here at this point in the game.
Misses the second. Casey gobbles up the rebound. Unofficially, he has 15.
Not a bad evening's work, and we still have 5 minutes
remaining. Plus 13 points.
Double-double.
Van Pelt backs out. Gets around Doughty this time, and the shot still won't go. Casey, the rebound and the follow. Three-pointer for Doughty won't go. Baker, the rebound. The follow wouldn't go, but Casey got the foul. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Casey with his fourth.
You're able to palm the basketball, aren't you? I was watching Casey palm it. No, you can't?
No.
Oh, that was a baseball. That's right. Sorry.
Maybe even a softball. No, I might be able to palm a girls' ball, girls' basketball, because it's a little smaller. But certainly not a regulation boys' basketball, size basketball. Baker able to hit 1 of 2.
7-point lead for the Pirates with under 5 minutes remaining in this ballgame.
Casey driving. Too much on it. Follow wouldn't go. And now a foul on the third opportunity. We'll put Lynn at the line.
Call Townsend on this one. Yep.
That's number four on Townsend.
Four on Townsend, four on Baker.
Second one is short. Townsend the rebound. Another rebound for the Pirates.
Well, Doughty able to gain the lane in the hole, but just couldn't get it to fall.
Knowles up top for McClellan. Left side, Van Pelt dumps it off for Lynn. Baseline scores.
10-point lead for Park Center.
Driving is Townsend for the basket. Cardinals with the numbers. Townsend out, Nagley will drive. It's not gonna go, rebound, Townsend hits it.
Good job, Blair, right there. Get the poke out and the bucket. 6-point lead now for Park Center.
Should be four.
.340 remaining in this ball game. It's been a frustrating one, I think, for Coon Rapids. And Joe Yen.
It's been interesting.
Yes, it has.
Hasn't been the prettiest basketball game I've ever seen.
No.
It's been entertaining.
Well, there's no doubt about that.
Confusing.
Interesting.
Interesting is a good word.
Definitely not an instant classic.
Not unless this last 338 has some pretty cool in store. Pull-up jumper won't go for Van Pelton. All's hung up there for about an hour to get that rebound. And the Pirates' domination on the glass has continued. Baker, the bucket, plus the foul on Knowles. That'll be his third.
Yeah, and that's a foolish foul because he had the bucket. Now you give him an opportunity for a three-point play. It should never happen.
Basket is good by Baker. Ball on the Pirates' number 11, Voltaire Knowles. The basket is good. That's Voltaire's third. Baker will shoot one more.
And Baker gets the roll. 5-point lead again. Townsend nearly had a hand in on it. Casey driving, and he gets the roll.
Big basket for Casey.
Whose building is this again? The chain of defense. Baker underneath scores.
Well, the Cardinals don't want to trade baskets here at this point. They want to get stops on defense.
Van Pelt looking for room against Latta. Casey waves from the basket, won't get it. Lynn, second chance, but that won't go.
That could have been Ben's
Cardinals
fifth.
On the run. Baker, Townsend rather, draws the foul, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
That's going to be Knowles, it'll be his fourth. Big free throws here for Blair.
It's the first. And he hits them both. 3-point game. And I've got Townsend for 11 points now. Cardinals trying to trap up away from the basket. Here's McClellan stepping in. His jumper won't go. Beam tracks down the rebound. Beam at the other end, an offensive foul. Knowles did a nice job of planting his feet.
Oh, he had plenty of time to plant his feet. That was a play that maybe Beam should have pulled up and set something up offensively.
Nice play by Voltaire Knowles.
Yep.
2 minutes remaining. Park Center's lead is three. My opinion should be one, but.
Now Park Center, regardless. You know, would just move clock time off the clock at this point.
Casey turns, steps in, hands off Van Pelt, the bucket and the foul.
They call that one on Lotta, I believe. Oh, nope. They're going to call that on Ben, and that's five.
Basket by number three, Therese Van Pelt is good. He was fouled on the play by the Cardinals number 14, Ben Baker. That is Ben's fifth personal foul. Again, the basket was good. Van Pelt will shoot.
It was good movement by Casey.
Yep.
Turning, recognizing he had room, and there was only one defender for he and two teammates. Walks right. The no look. And Baker called for the foul. Van Pelt scores anyhow. He's now got 10. His first trip to the free throw line. And he hits it.
Lead push back to 6 for Park Center.
Beam kicks it out. Nagley on the right side working against Knowles. Back to Beam. Beam driving to the lane. Left-hander won't go. Got his own rebound. Jumped right into Casey. Townsend will finish it off, and a timeout for Coon Rapids.
That puts, 127 remaining, 4-point lead for Park Center, and a good timeout for Coon Rapids. Talk about things a little bit. Pressure on defense. Not afford to let Park Center take time off the clock.
And the strategy would be completely different if my feeling is correct. And this is a two-point game, not a four-point game.
Well, absolutely. Then you can play and you can let them take a little time off the clock and not have to worry. But we'll see if Coon Rapids goes for it. See if they get a foul early on. An opportunity to put Park Center at the line. An opportunity for a miss in the basketball.
The Pirates have not been outstanding at the free throw line. They haven't been terrible, but
it's a nail biter. Cardinals are going to pressure.
Try and make it difficult for McClellan to get it in, and they do, and
yeah,
force him to take the timeout. Notice he called it at about 2 or 3, though. He wasn't going to let it go to 4.
Apparently that was the magic number at 4. Again, the Cardinals will have to go back on defense, do the same thing they did on that possession, and then limit the opportunity that Park Center has to throw the ball in and see if they can get a turnover. I think Park Center realized they have to they get a quick inbound pass. We'll see if Coon Rapids comes out and fouls quickly.
McClellan will take it again on the baseline. Cardinals lining up man-to-man. Inbound gets to Casey. And Abel got a finger on it. Casey did not touch it. Still Park Center ball. Inbound goes to Knowles.
Let him play.
Into the front court, left side for McClellan. Back to Knowles. Van Pelt quickly to Casey. No look pass in the bucket for Jordan Lynn.
That was a great job by Casey with that no look pass because it moved the defense away from that side of the bucket.
Beam driving. He'll get the bucket and the foul on Lynn.
Big free throw for Cody Beam. Cut the lead to a single possession.
I've got him at 3 of 4 from the free throw line. 13 points off the bench. He misses. Out of bounds, Coon Rapids ball. And they need to make this possession count.
Got 1 minute left. Adam Nagley coming into the ball game. Big 3-point opportunity for him on the court.
1 minute remaining. Cardinals trail by four. Inbound to Townsend. And I'm surprised you didn't go right at Casey. Nall's got the steal but stepped out of bounds.
Yeah. That's fortunate for Coon Rapids.
With Casey out there, I would think you go right at him with his four fouls. And you got a guy like either Abel or Blair Townsend is going to be more athletic. And there's a foul that'll put Nagley at the line to shoot two. Foul's going to be on Knowles, his fourth. Oh, that's his fifth.
That's his fifth, yep.
Nagley with two big free throws here, 49 seconds remaining. Nagley's first trip to the free throw line tonight. That one rolled around and out.
That's a tough one.
And he hits the second one. It's a three-point game.
A lot of back into the action for the Cardinals. Three-point lead for Park Center with 49 seconds remaining.
Inbound. Action on the floor, out of bounds to Coon Rapids.
Wow.
Pressure defense pays off. They did not have to commit a foul, and they get the ball back, a chance to tie it from the perimeter.
And Nagley back into the game now. They want his opportunity from the perimeter.
Nagley calls timeout.
A good defense by Park Center, not allowing Nagley the inbound pass. You see the scrum underneath.
Dowdy got a finger on it.
Yep, a nice job by Lotta, just kind of tipping it ahead.
How was that Coon Rapids ball?
Yeah, it looked kind of like it went off red, didn't it?
Okay.
Nonetheless, well, you know, that's kind of part of the course for this game.
I still say it should be a one-point game.
You haven't pled your case well enough, apparently, to the score table.
It's not really my job
I know,
to do
well,
that.
I know, but, you know. It seemed to work the last time. Oh, it did go off. Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. Absolutely.
Was tipped out by Van Pelt. Good call, ref. Cardinal ball, 45 seconds left. They trail by three. Dowdy up top, driving. Gets the bucket. It's a one-point game. Other end, McClellan throws up a prayer. Swan got it back. He's fouled, but he wasn't able to get it to go. So he'll have a chance to put it back to a three-point lead. What?
Yeah. Well, originally he called the basket good. That would have been definitely.
There would have been the extra 2 points, though. That, Lynn, 3 for 5 from the free throw line. And finally, some noise from the Cardinal fans when the opposition is at the free throw line.
It took until 27 seconds left in this ball game for the crowd to get off their feet and make a little noise.
Trying to make it a 2-point game. He can't do it. Casey, the rebound, knocked away. Got it back, blocked by Abel. Got it back again. Goes to the floor. Timeout called by Adam Nagley.
Wow.
And I'm not quite sure how Casey wasn't fouled there.
Nonetheless, Coon Rapids gets possession of the basketball.
With a one-point game.
Yeah.
19 seconds.
They're going to see it there. Oh, that was a clean block there.
That was clean, but tell me there was no foul there.
There was a foul. There was definitely contact on the arm there, but fortunately the Cardinals got away with one.
Abel got a big block right there. Unofficially his second. Yeah, that would have been, I believe Townsend might have committed a foul there that he got away with.
A little bit.
But, I mean, what do I know? In my book, Coon Rapids is on top by one. Is there a chance that I could be right about that twice in one night?
I
must not be right. The scoreboard, I'm sure, has got to be right because I was right the first time.
So, in other words, law of averages, it evens out.
That's right.
Big possession for Coon Rapids.
Huge possession.
1 point down.
Seconds.
Now obviously, you got to be careful if you're Park City.
Full court pressure by the Pirates. See, and now the chance of defense from the visiting fans. Beam looking for room. Got around the corner and a foul. That's number 5 on Casey. And it'll put one of the Cardinals' best free throw shooters at the line with a chance to put him in front with under 8 seconds to play.
You know, if you wouldn't have slipped, he may have opportunity to get the bucket there. He kind of slipped into Casey.
That may be another fan foul. Perhaps.
Perhaps.
Because, yeah, it looked to me like he just slipped.
He kind of slipped into Casey. And
yeah,
then
Casey had maybe grabbed him quick, but I don't think that was the case. Fouls going both ways.
Wow.
Cody Beam at the line with a chance to put Coon Rapids in front. He ties the game with that one.
Instant classic, Joe. Now you're going to call it an instant
classic? Something very interesting did happen in the last couple of minutes.
Oh, my.
See, and I already wrote down that he hit both free throws on my book, so probably wrong. But it's not. He hits them both, puts Coon Rapids in lead by one with 7.8 seconds remaining.
Well, now if you're Coon Rapids, you just got to play tight defense, but not foul.
And I believe this is Park Center's final timeout.
Yeah, they did have one left.
This is not, that would not allow them the opportunity to try and get into the front court and then set up a new play. And be sure the Cardinals will show full court pressure.
Yeah.
And make Park Center work to get it across midcourt. And like you said, just try not to commit the foul.
Most of this gymnasium on their feet here with the final 7.8. Coon Rapids with that now slimmest of slim 1 point leads. So for the Cardinals, you have Abo Blair, Mike Latta, Cody Beam, and Torrin Dowdy on the floor.
Dubois will inbound for the Pirates. Cardinals are going to pressure the inbound to McClellan. Driving the base. Blocked by Abel. Another block. And a foul. And Blair can't believe it.
You have to be kidding me.
No. No, I can't. And that's number 5 on Blair. 1.4
seconds.
Let's
see this again. There's the first block. You can't see it from this angle. I don't know if we have a better angle.
Saying that he came over the back? Is that what it was?
Okay, let's see on this angle. There's the first block.
Clean block.
Oh, well, he got him on the hand, but I think the ball was gone.
Either way, 1.4 seconds remaining, and Jordan Lynn going to be at the line to shoot two humongous free throws. Blair got that rebound thinking that was securing a victory. Instead, he's called for the foul. And now Lynn, who just missed a couple, has another opportunity. He missed it. One more, a chance to tie with 1.4.
And the
Cardinals have to remember to box out.
Exactly. They must box out at this point if they miss. He misses that one.
And he does. Abel pokes it away. The Cardinals are going to hold on for an amazing victory.
Wow. You talk about an amazing victory, is right, Joe Yund.
Even a more difficult victory than it should have been, I believe.
Yeah,
I
no
still,
doubt.
I still argue my that they won this one by three
two.
And not one.
Or
but
two.
By three.
Oh, three.
That's my argument. There were two phantom points in the second
right.
half. Either way, the Cardinals had a big lead in the first half, went to locker room trailing, came back to a tie game in the second half because it changed between the end of the first half and the
correct.
Beginning of the second. And then they found themselves trailing most of the second half, but able to come back and get the victory. We'll take a break. We will take a break, and we will be back with some post-game reaction and wrap-up after this. Second season starts right now. Wow, do we have a show for you tonight?
Come out! Busy afternoon Monday for firefighters trying to contain several grass fires along.
This is going to be a very good and very close game.
Welcome to Sports Night. I'm Joe Young.
And I'm Howie Sproy.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Talk of the Town.
Such a big event definitely needs a third man.
I am folding the pants. The pants are long. Do they go on my head? Do they? Do the pants go on my head? No. They go on
Everyday moments can become teaching moments because learning starts long before school does. Give your child the start they need at bornlearning.org.
I remember how much you said you liked mine. Oh.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you.
Thinking about the dish? Look what you lose.
Going deep!
Item six is to consider conditional use permit and site plan.
A kitchen fire the day after Christmas sent a Coon Rapids man to the hospital.
It helped her overcome being so critical of herself.
Congratulations, class of 2000.
Our new 2000 Miss Coon Rapids.
And he makes the catch!
Don't be a loser. Stay informed with Community Cable.
Global warming. Some say irreversible consequences are 30 years away. 30 years? That won't affect me.
At Roger E. Carlson Fieldhouse, the Cardinals with a one-point victory over the Park Center Pirates. I'm joined now by head coach Aaron Wilford and also one of the stars, Cody Beam. First of all, Cody, how intense was it those last couple minutes?
The last couple minutes was pretty intense, but during the free throws, I just took my time. And as he says, I do rapid fire, but don't know, I just shot them and they went in.
Did you guys had a nice lead in the first half, but lost it. They played well, and they led most of that second half. Was there any doubt in your guys' mind that you could come back and get the victory?
No doubt, yeah. I thought we could do it. Just had to run, make some shots.
And at the end, you were the one calling for the ball and taking it to the hole. When you got that foul, what was it like going to the free throw line knowing you had a chance to put yourselves in the lead with under 10 seconds to play?
I don't know, it was just like any other free throw. I just went up there, did my routine, and just made them.
So. And now how does it feel to be winners of three straight?
Feels good. Just get a couple more, string a few more, and hopefully do a lot better.
Congratulations on the win. On the other side, head coach Aaron Wilford and coach, how does it feel for you to be kind of in a very stressful game and finally come out from behind and get the victory at the end?
You know, I think it's exciting to see how our players perform. And I think that's the best part is, as Cody mentioned, you know, no doubt in our minds. Well, I mean, let's be honest, coaches start watching the clock and you start looking at what's going on. But I think the best proof is what Cody said. They didn't give up. They kept working hard. And you know, we hit some shots. We got finally a few rebounds, and you know, I think Cody did a great job down the stretch. Took the ball to the basket hard, and then the pressure was on him to step up and knock him down. He did a nice job, and you know, I thought we did a fairly good job the last 7 seconds. You know, we stopped the first push, gave up another offensive rebound, but one player steps up and knocks him down, and I guess on the other end we come out ahead because somebody else didn't. So.
Three wins in a row, now 5-3 in the conference. What has changed? Have you seen any changes over those last couple games? What are you guys doing better now that you hadn't been doing earlier on?
You know, I think some of what we've been doing a better job of is finishing. You know, tonight, as was mentioned, we had a little early lead, and then the second half we kind of gave it up. But you know, I think the game is a game of runs, and we were kind of able to answer the run that they made. And sometimes I think it just comes down to a little luck and somebody making a play. So,
well, congratulations on the win here tonight. It was certainly fun for us. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the second half. The Park Center Pirates built that lead up, but the Cardinals stayed around. Good movement in transition. Baker scoring. Casey created problems all night on the offensive end. He gets the bucket and the foul there. And some sloppy play on both ends. Voltaire Knowles with a nice night. Scores on the fast break there. And then underneath, Jordan Lynn coming in big late in the game. Cody Beam, a bucket and a foul. He came on strong off the bench and then especially strong in the second half. Torin Dowdy with a nice stretch there, I think had 6 points in a row for the Cardinals. And he talked about those rebounds for Coon Rapids were big and a lot of missed free throws for the Pirates down the stretch. How he's about how important those free throws are and hitting those. Lynn had a couple of opportunities in the last minute to ice the game for Park Center. He was unable to do so, and the Cardinals come away victorious.
Man, a satisfying win is that for Coon Rapids. I'm sure disheartening for Park Center because they had the opportunity at least to tie it, not win it and win the game. So you look at that game, and it was, we talked about sloppy at points. Got to give credit to both teams just really fighting and staying in the end of the game. But I thought Cody Beam did a great job. Cool as ice from the free throw line and an opportunity to get the win for his team. And a nice win for Coon Rapids. As you mentioned, 3 in a row, 5-3 in the conference. And that bodes well for them because it gives them that much more confidence.
All right. Well, a big victory for the Cardinals tonight. A 1-point win, a come from behind win for the Cardinals. It improves their winning streak to 3 and their conference record to 5-3, now 7-8. Overall, here's a look at what we have coming up for you here on CTN. We're going to see the boys basketball team again next Tuesday. A little bit higher level of competition. The Maple Grove Crimson are, I believe, third in the conference, third or fourth. And the Cardinals right there with them. So they will hope to continue this winning streak. And then we'll see girls basketball, Blaine against the Cardinals on Friday, February 6th. On Tuesday the 10th. Boys basketball again. The Cardinals taking on some of the cream of the crop, The Centennial Cougars, one of the better teams in the Northwest Suburban Conference. So some great action coming up for you here on CTN in the next couple of weeks. Again, the final score from Roger E. Carlson, it's Coon Rapids 77, Park Center 76. Want to thank everybody out there for joining us and continuing to support everything we do here at CTN. For the entire crew, including Howie Shapiro, I'm Joe Young. Say goodnight.